Good morning students, how are you all? In our today's English class, we will be doing literature lesson 3, The Brogue. Now, Brogue is the name of a horse. Now, basically his name is Brogue, but people say that his name should be Rogue, R-O-G-U-E. Rogue means badmash. Okay, because this horse is although a tamed animal, but he behaves like a wild horse. Now, because of this horse, a girl's wedding is in danger. Now, let's read in this story how. Can a horse ruin the chances of a young girl getting married to an eligible bachelor? Eligible bachelor का मतलब होता है एक लड़का जो शादी के योग्य हो, जिसमें सारे गुण हो. The hunting season was over, but the mullets had still not been able to see Brogue. The family had hoped for years that someone, the family had hoped for years that someone would buy the Brogue before the hunting was over. Now, mullets is the name of the family, the surname of the family, and basically they want to sell their horse. But seasons came and went and still the horse was theirs. The animal has been named Crazy One at first. He was later renamed the Brogue because, like a heavy Irish accent, he was very difficult to get rid of. Someone in the neighborhood had suggested that first letter of his name was unnecessary, and that is Rogue, meaning a wild, bad person, was even more suitable. So as I told you that his name was Crazy One, and then they renamed it to Brogue, and then someone in the neighbor said that his name should be Rogue, jiska meaning hota hai badmash or the bad person. And these people, they wanted to sell their horse. Now seasons came and went, but they were unable to sell their horse. Toby Mullet had ridden him for 4 seasons. Now till from 4 seasons they were riding this horse. Toby is the son. The Brogue knew the countryside well, having personally made most of the holes in the bushes and fences for many miles around. Now the writer is saying that this horse, he knew all the roads. Okay, and basically why he knew, because most of the holes on the roads and fences and hedges were made by him only. He used to go and bang into anywhere. The Brogue manners and characteristics were not ideal for hunting. Not ideal for hunting means basically he was not a hunting horse. You could not go on hunting on that horse. But he was probably safer to ride in a hunt than on a country roads. बट अगर उसके देखा जाए तो इट वॉज सेफ कि अगर आप बाहर गाँव में लेके जाओ रादर देन इन सिटीज, बिकॉज ही यूज्ड टू गो एंड बैंग इन टू एनी थिंग. कहीं भी वो भड़क जाता था एनिमल्स को या चीज़ों को देख करके. सो इट वॉज नॉट सेफ टू गो इन द बिजी रोड्स ऑन दैट हॉर्स, रादर यू कुड गो ऑन द ओपन कंट्री साइड. अकॉर्डिंग टू मुलिट्स फैमिली, ही वॉज नॉट रियली अफ्रेड ऑफ रोड्स. But there were one or two things which caused him to jump about rather wildly. Now this horse, basically he was not afraid of the traffic or anything on the road. But the only thing was that he used to see some things and suddenly start jumping and start behaving in a wild manner. He would ignore motor cars and bicycle. Means he was not bothered about the motor cars or the cycles going on the road. But wheelbarrows, piles of stones by the roadside, baby carriages means jo jisme babies ko leke jaate hain, in a village street and very white gates, all made him start off suddenly in clear imitations of. Now when he saw all these things, he used to suddenly start jumping. Lightning zigzag course. He used to go in a zigzag manner. इधर से उधर भागने लगता था ये सब चीज़ें देख करके. If a bird flew noisily, means when a bird used to take flight, making noise, the ground, the Brogue would spring into the air at the same moment. But this may have been to keep it company. Now if he saw a bird taking off flight from the ground, he also used to start jumping along with it, as if he was trying to give company to the bird to fly. It was about the third week in May that Mrs. Mullet, mother of Toby, and a number of daughters ran into Clovis Sangrail in the village. She told him all the local news, speaking with great excitement. Now she went to visit the friend in the neighborhood, and all the local news they used to share. You know our neighbor, our new neighbor, Mr. Pancrate, she said, very rich, owns several business in Cornwall, middle-aged and rather quiet. Now she is discussing about a new neighbor who has just recently come in there near their house to stay. He is now living in the red house. Well, Toby's sold him the brogue. Now she is telling that my son Toby has sold the horse to this man. Clovis spent a moment or two considering this amazing news. Then he told her how happy he was for them. First he heard the news and then he said, okay, it's really good news that finally your horse is sold. How wonderful, lucky to have done it at last. Now you can buy a decent horse. I have always said that Toby was clever. Ever so many congratulations. Now the friend is saying that congratulations, that finally see Toby is an intelligent boy, I always said, and see how well he has done. He has sold the horse and now you will purchase a good decent horse. Don't congratulate me. It's the most unfortunate thing that could happen, said Mrs. Mullet dramatically. Now Mrs. Mullet is saying, oh, don't congratulate. It is the most ungrateful thing which has happened. Now what was this thing? Let's see. Clovis stared at her in amazement. You see, said Mrs. Mullet in an excited whisper, Mr. Pancrate rather likes Jessie, my daughter. I was a fool not to have seen it sooner. Yesterday at a garden party, he asked her what her favorite flowers were. She told him roses, and today a whole stack of roses arrived with a box of chocolates that he must have got from London. And he's asked her to play golf with him tomorrow. And now, just at this important moment, Toby has sold him that horse. It's a disaster. Now she's telling her feelings. See that Toby has been sold to this man and he has proposed to my daughter. He has asked her to play golf with her and he asked her her favorite flowers and he sent her those flowers and he sent a box of chocolates also. So basically this is a disaster that we have sold this nuisance horse to this young man. But you've been trying to get rid of the horse for years, said Clovis. So Clovis is trying to tell her that, see, basically you wanted to get rid of the horse. So it is good that you have sold the horse to him. I've got a house full of daughters, said Mrs. Mullet. And I have been trying well not to get rid of them, of course. But a husband or two would certainly be welcome. There are six of them, you know. I don't know, said Clovis. I've never counted, but I expected you right as to be the number. Mothers generally know these things. Now, Clovis is Mrs. Mullet is saying, see, I have so many daughters and I wanted to get my daughters married. I am not in a hurry, but then of course if I get a good match, then I would like to get my daughters married. And you know, I have six of them. So the friend says, oh, I don't know, I never counted your daughters, but maybe you are right, because mothers are generally right in all these things. So maybe if you are saying you have six daughters, so maybe you are having six daughters. So, and she says, see, now I've got a good match for my daughter and now all this thing has happened. And now, continued Mrs. Mullet in dramatic whisper, when there's a rich man who might actually marry one, Toby sells him that terrible animal. It will probably kill him if he tries to ride it. Anyway, it will kill any love he might have felt towards Jessie. What is it to be done? So now Mrs. Mullet says, ki, see, yes, I was wanting to sell the horse, but I also wanted to get my daughters married. Now when some nice boy is getting one of my daughters married, now all this thing has happened. And if that man tries to ride this horse, he is definitely going to be killed. You cannot very well tell him the truth. You see, we praised it so highly to him and said it was a wonderful animal. Now she's saying that we also cannot say that the truth to this young man, because when we sold the horse, we were praising this animal. So now we cannot tell him the truth also. Something must be done, and at once. The man is not used to horses, and I believe I told him it was quite a lamb. After all, lambs go kicking and twisting about as if they're mad, don't they? Now she says, ki, something we will try to do, but I have told him that my horse is a lamb. You know, lamb means jo bhed ka jo bachcha hota hai, usko lamb bolte, L-A-M-B. Now lamb, she's saying, ki, see, lambs are basically innocent animals. They go on kicking and jumping and running around. So same way is my horse. It will go kicking and jumping and running about. So basically my horse also is like a lamb. So what I told him was correct. The lamb has an entirely false reputation of calmness, agreed Clovis. Now Clovis was trying to explain that by lamb we mean that innocent person or an innocent animal, but here Mrs. Mullet is trying to give a different meaning, totally different meaning to the word lamb. Jesse came back from the golf game the next day, both happy and worried. Now next day, as I told earlier, that Mrs. Mullet was telling the friend that Jesse was invited to play golf. So next day when she comes back after playing golf, she was happy also and she was worried also. Now let's see why. It's all right about the marriage, she said. He proposed and I accepted. Now she is telling that, see, he proposed me for the marriage and I accepted his proposal. The daughter is telling the mother. By the way, he is coming over this evening to ask your permission. So for all's well, but about the brogue, it's a different matter. I told him the story about how much we wanted to buy the horse back, but he seems very set on keeping it. He said he must have a horse now that he's living in the country. He's going to start riding tomorrow. Now the daughter is telling all the story what happened there. She's saying, see, he proposed me and I accepted, and tomorrow he is coming to meet you. And the thing is that he wants to ride the horse. Now tomorrow he is thinking of riding the horse. Although she told him that we want the horse back. We want to purchase the horse back. But this young man wanted to keep the horse. And he now, because he is staying in the countryside, so he also wanted a horse. He has ridden a few times before this on an animal that used to carry 80 years olds. Now the daughter is saying, although he's ridden horses earlier also, but I do not know whether this type of horse. That's all about his experience with horses, and tomorrow he's going to ride the brogue. I shall be a widow before I'll married, and I do so want to see what Greece is like. It looks so silly in the map. Vincent has promised to take me to Greece for our honeymoon. Clovis was sent for immediately and told the situation. Now the daughter is telling the mother that, see, I do not know what will happen, and before I get married I'll become a widow, and I really want to go to Greece because I want to see what Greece looks like, because basically the young man has promised him to take for honeymoon to Greece, and in the map the Greece looks a silly place, but I want to visit Greece. So again, now all this news was to be shared with Clovis, the friend. So immediately he was sent for. Nobody can ride that animal with any safety, said Mrs. Mullet, except Toby, because he knows exactly what frightens it and it's somehow prepared. Now they are discussing about the horse that, see, except Toby, nobody can ride that horse, because Toby is now known to the horse and he knows everything about the horse, that what makes the horse upset. said. So only he can ride the horse now, and this young man is wanting to take the horse tomorrow. I didn't hint to Mr. Pancrate, to Vincent, I should say that the brogue didn't like white gates, said Jessie. White gates, exclaimed Mrs. Mullet. Did you mention what effect a pig has on him? He'll have to go past Lockyer's farm to get the high road, and there's sure to be a pig or two playing about in the lane. Now they're discussing that how wild he gets looking at the white gates. Now they're saying that white gates, when he sees the pig, he becomes even more worst. So they're saying basically he has to go round the farmhouse because he cannot go and see the pigs. He cannot. The brogue's taken a dislike to turkeys lately as well, said Toby. Now Toby's informing them that see, now recently the horse has taken a dislike to turkeys also. So basically there are turkeys also people are having in their farmhouse. It's obvious that Pandicate mustn't be allowed to go out in that animal, said Clovis. At least not till Jessie has married him and is tied to him. I tell you what, ask him to a picnic tomorrow, starting at an early hour. He's not the sort to go out for a ride before breakfast. The day after, I'll find an excuse to take him on a drive. The brogue will be standing idle in the stable, and Toby can offer to exercise it. Then it can pick up a stone or something of the sort and conveniently become lame. If you hurry on the wedding a bit, the lameless story can be kept up till the ceremony is safely over. Now basically they are planning out that tomorrow we can do one thing, that we plan out for a picnic early morning, we leave early morning, and this man, of course, early in the morning he will not go to ride on the horse. So we plan out a picnic for tomorrow whole day, and then Toby can say that he want to exercise the horse and somehow try to hurt the horse leg with a stone, and then the horse will become lame, and then they should hurry with the wedding, and the lame horse is standing idle there in the stable. So basically the young man will not get to ride the horse. It was nobody's fault that it poured with rain the next morning, making picnic impossible. It was also nobody's fault but plain ill luck that the weather cleared up in the afternoon so that Pancrate could try the first ride of the brogue. Now, it was nobody's mistake. What happened is that next morning from morning it started raining, so they could not go for picnic. And to their bad luck, what happened is that in the afternoon the rain stopped. Now this young man thought of taking the horse on a ride. They did not get as far as the pigs of Lockie's farm. The church gate was painted dull green, but it had been white a year or two ago, and the brogue never forgot he had been in the habit of making a violent turn, twist and jump at this particular point of the road. Then he broke his way into someone's garden, where he found a turkey in a cage. Later, the garden's owner found the cage almost whole, but very little left for the turkey. Now, he took the horse, he took it via the pig's farm, then from the church gate. Of course, the church gate was painted white, but recently it has been painted green. But the horse remembered that from here, he used to take a steep turn back. So he turned, took a steep turn back, and then he banged into the turkey's gate as he saw the turkeys, and the turkey's gate was broken. Only a little bit of the gate was left. Mr. Pancrate was a little shaken and suffered from a hurt knee and some other damages. Now this young man, he had hurt here and there. He got hurt on his knee and little bit here and there he got some bruises. But he good naturedly blamed his own inexperience with the horse and country roads. Now this man was a good natured man, so he did not blame the horse, but he said that of course this is a country road and the roads are ups and downs, and basically I have no experience of riding a horse, so that is why all this happened. In the list of weddings present, which the local newspapers published a week or so later, appeared the following items. Now, after a week, the wedding took place, and the list of items what the got as a present: brown riding horse, the brogue, the bridegroom's gift to the bride. Which shows that Toby Mullet, that he knew nothing, or else said Clovis, that he has a very pleasing sense of humor. Now, what happened is that this young man presented that horse to his wife, Jessie, on the wedding day. Now, this you say it is as a sense of humor that he presented the same thing, that same animal back to his wife, or maybe he knew, did not know anything about the horse and innocently he gifted the horse to his wife. So that is basically the story about the horse, and I will send you the question answers in the PDF.